Shkvalo of the Ukraine. But Shkvalo remains on the bench so far. And Russia, regardless of the result, will be taking home their fourth successive Paralympic medal. They won silver in Atlanta, gold in Sydney, and bronze in Athens. Anatoly Shevchuk, just in a bit of trouble there, after Kovaev's fairly reckless challenge. Earns Russia their third yellow card of the match. So they're going to have to be careful here, the Russians. Shevchuk does seem okay. Good work down the wing from the captain. Feeds it into Vitaly Trushev. He made a storming run up from the back. But he couldn't get a shot on goal. Better now from Ukraine at the start of this second half. Kovaev trying to create something. And Antonio, the captain from Ukraine, he just made that run down the wing a moment ago. Said after the semi-final victory that they don't have the confidence to win all the matches. Not quite sure what he meant by that. He says they still have a chance of victory in a final. He did say their opponents, the Russians, will be very tough to handle. Certainly scoring 25 goals, conceding just the one, you would think would give Ukraine a fair bit of confidence. It's been pretty even so far. About one real decent chance for each side in the first half. Devlish trying to be a bit clever. But concedes the corner. Chesman will take it. Thank you. Vladimir Antoniuk. Just trying to keep the ball in there, but they're already run out. Ukraine now on the attack. Ball just running a little bit too long for Shevchuk. He'd wanted the ball earlier when he first started that run. Six minutes gone here in the second half. And still, no goals. Both sets of forwards have been operating on full cylinders throughout this tournament. But they've been cancelled out by some pretty solid defences here. Shevchuk got a good look at that header. Couldn't pull it round far enough. And it seems now just a matter of time before the Ukrainian top scorer, Ivan Shkvalo, will make an appearance in this match and try and break the deadlock. This is Antoniuk. Kovaev now for Russia. Crucial clearance there from Taras Dutko. Because there was a Russian just lurking at the far post. And if he hadn't cut that ball out, I think it was Chesmin who would have been there to pounce. Devlish just going down there. Ovenanze not looking too happy with the decision. Just a bit of a tangle. More than anything malicious. Devlish takes up a position on that near post. There he is. Well, the ref just seeing something he didn't like. Guido Gonzalez from Ecuador. And Dukka will have another chance here. Well, it was chipped in to the far post towards Vitali Trushev. And he struck his volley pretty cleanly. But Lekhov was there. Solid save. Good technique there from Trushev, outside of the boot. And you have to wonder when Ovcharenko is going to bring on the striker who has scored 7 goals for Ukraine so far in this tournament, Ivan Shkvarlo. Kovayev there battling. Passes it out to Patekin. Can't keep the ball in play. But the captain will get the roll in there. Antoniuk looks like he might have been clear there, but he was caught and couldn't get a shot off. Well, the Ukrainian coach still looking pretty bored. Too far away at all from Lasha Mavanadze. So Mashka had it well covered though. The match just beginning to open up a little bit more. You feel as if the deadlock might be broken sooner rather than later. Shevchuk just having his legs whipped away from under him by Pavel Borisov, who's already on a yellow card. Antoniak looks to tee himself up. Thank you. Well, we're in the final quarter of this match and still no goals. Baramids for that. Wondering what his side has to do to break down this stubborn Ukrainian defence. Devilish wins the corner. And still no sign of Ivan Shikvalo. Ukrainian players saying how much energy they used up in that semi-final victory over Brazil. And already speaking ahead of this match as if that was really going to affect them come the final. And the match has been a little bit flat from the standards that these two sides have set. But here's Kovaev.